It's been called a crisis. It's been called an epidemic. Words that perhaps are thrown around so often we are deadened to the meanings behind them. But we're talking about the opiate problem throughout really the entire country. It's no longer a city problem. It's not a country problem. It's not a rural problem. It's not an urban problem. It's a problem facing all of us. We're joined now by Dr. Trudy Pieper to talk about the opioid problem. And the fact is there are some really staggering statistics out there about this growing issue.
It's amazing. Painkiller overdose kills more than one American every hour of every day. I mean, that's just huge. The CDC is so concerned about it that they're saying that the prescription overdose is epidemic. 46 people a day die, and the treatment has actually become the problem. When you have pain and when it runs to get a painkiller, and what they've noticed is that when pain prescriptions go up, deaths also go up. The opiates kill as many people as heroin and cocaine combined. 250 million prescriptions for the painkillers are given out every year. 250 million. That means every adult person in the United States can have their own bottle of painkiller. The 10 highest prescribing states are found in the South, Alabama, Tennessee, and West Virginia. But those of us in the Midwest are not exempt. We're the next three. Ohio, Indiana, and Michigan give out someplace between 100 and 143 prescriptions for every 100 people. It continues to grow. I think the common drugs that people are most familiar with are methadone, oxycodone, and hydrocodone. The emergency rooms are laden with 1,000 people each day per emergency room come in because of pain reliever overdose. Over 2 million people are determined to be addicted or dependent upon the painkillers, and overdoses and deaths have quadrupled since 1999.
You know, and we hear about this, and I think a lot of people, the thought is, oh, well, you know, prescription drugs, well, it can lead to other things, but what the stats are telling us is that it's deadlier to be addicted to painkillers, to prescription drugs, than it can be to heroin or cocaine.
Exactly. There are more people who die from that than put the other two together. We've gotten very convenient. Every little ache and pain, we want to have a painkiller. We run to the doctors, they prescribe them. The drug companies are glad to accommodate that. But at the end of the day, it is not helping us, it's not helping our body. And the addiction to that, in addition to the harm it's doing to the body, is just terrific with that. And it's unnecessary.
And you look at the fact that you've got doctors who are overprescribing, you've got the so-called pill mills that are making plenty of money off of this. So it's a cycle between those two organizations that are really killing people.
They are. And we need to turn that around. And that's the great news, that there are a lot of natural things you can do that will stop pain in your body. Just a knowledge about that and keeping it on hand. One really easy is white willow bark. And I always laugh because it's very similar. You see dogs chewing bark. Now, why is that dog chewing the bark? Do they want to play with it? No, because bark has saccharin in it, which is the ingredient in aspirin. So they're really getting pain relief naturally from the bark. So getting white willow bark, which is the original aspirin, is overall, for any kind of overall pain reliever, it's great, and it doesn't affect the stomach like aspirin does. Meadow sweet is another very common. It helps with digestive pain, arthritis, and if you have a fever, it will bring down your fever. Kava kava is used as a muscle relaxant. Devil's claw is both pain and inflammation for joints, but it has a great affinity for back. And back problems are huge today. If you're having back problems, devil's claw is something you should keep on hand and use per bottle ingredients. And then St. John's wort, if you're having nervous tension, you got a nervous tension headache, or you've noticed it in your neck, or you're holding it in your shoulders, a little St. John's wort will probably take care of that.
There are, as you just detailed, several herbal solutions. What are some other ways we can get around this opiate problem?
Well, another, there's two more herbs I like to mention because they're the most powerful. And if you want to compare apples to apples as to what will do the equal the opioids, the first one is curcumin. And this is just, you can find this in most homes. It's a spice that people use. It's an ingredient found in turmeric. And it is a powerful antioxidant, anti-inflammatory. A recent study found that if you use 1 to 3 grams, now a teaspoon is a gram, worked better for pain than the prescription opioids with no side effects. It helps with general aches and pains, arthritis, neuropathy, exercise-induced pain, fibromyalgia. The key to it is that you want to make sure you spread it out throughout the day. I think in a powder form is better than in a capsule form, but you need to have it with black pepper because that speeds the results up. And another one that's really very effective is Boswellia. It's a unique pain remedy because of its ability to affect the 5-LOX LOX pathway of inflammation. And that's an analog that causes inflammation and causes direct pain. You see that a lot in arthritis and irritable bowel and autoimmune. Drugs like Lyrica, there's over 100 drugs that will do that, but probably Lyrica is one that most people are familiar with. That Boswellia worked better in studies than any of those drugs did. It improves the blood flow, and it takes about 1,000 milligrams per hour through the day to accomplish that.
So what you're saying is that if you're facing at home some sort of pain management issue, and your doctor wants to put you on an opioid, there are some other options that are all natural and, in the long term, probably healthier.
It is. The herbs, and in addition to that, one of the main causes of pain is dehydration. We, with all the caffeine drinks and the things that we drink each day, take into our bodies, America's dehydrated. So maybe just by increasing your fluids and making sure that you're getting 32 to 48 ounces of water each day, you will notice that your pain is less. Another thing is we're so underactive. Blood flow. Each one of these herbs I've talked about increases blood flow to the body. The more blood flow, the less pain you have. So the more active you have, the less pain you have. So getting out and taking a walk may be a better choice than taking a painkiller.
And I think that also goes hand in hand with another aspect, that as much as we want to prescribe something, a lot of times it comes down to some lifestyle choices.
It is. We're the only country in the world that depends upon drugs. The majority of 80% of the world uses herbs or lifestyle changes for their main healthcare system. So I think that in America it's too easy and we grab it and we think our insurance is going to pay for that. Long term though, these drugs, besides become addiction, they're foreign objects in your body. Your body's not used to them, and that triggers your immune system to have to attack them. So as they're attacking them, that lowers the immune system, which means now you're going to be more susceptible to colds and flu and other illnesses because you're taking these drugs.
All right. Thank you very much, Dr. Trudy Pieper. Some certainly eye-opening statistics about the growing opioid problem and some ways we can have solutions that are all natural. Of course, for more information, you can go to her website, phoenixwellnessforyou.com.